we're just looking for alternative cyclone bolt holes. Somewhere we can come if a big blow happens.
What are you doing?
Nothing on the bung.
This always freaks me out when he does this.
What is that?
And there was smoke in there, so we grabbed everything out of there. I was manning the fire extinguisher. Pina up the creek.
In the rain.
In the rain. It's been raining for days. That's a bit of an explore somewhere over there. What's happening?
Go for a spin. Rain. What you do?
What are you doing, babe? Because this is quite interesting.
We're just looking for alternative cyclone bolt holes. Somewhere we can come if a big blow happens. And I have heard that locals come down here during a big blow and tie off. So we're just having a bit of a poke around and see what we find. Got the echo sounder going. Just need to find about a 4 or 5 metre hole. 3 metres here. Lots of fish here. Sound up.
It's getting narrower and narrower, and I think we're nearly at the end, so we'll try another one.
Still 2.5 metres deep.
It's the end. Doing?
Nothing on the bung.
This always freaks me out when he does this.
What is that?
Is it nearly empty?
Yep. We go, all the water's gone.
Okay. Only not for the faint hearted.
Why?
Oh, you can catch me pulling a bung out of a boat.
I'm going to put a secondary bung in and so you can't scrub the inside.
According to the map, there's a walking track right there. Can you hear the cicadas?
What I find amazing is these gum trees growing here. Not so much the mangroves, but there's gum trees on your left.
mountains of fruit.
Oh, look at the ferns growing on the tree
there. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's just mangrove
forest. Oh, there they are.
It's a national park, remember?
End of the road.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, it's incredible. God,
pretty. Look at that there, the staghorns.
Yeah. Right, look at these beautiful fruit things, blobs. Does anybody know what these are? They're very large, like a grapefruit.
They look a bit like a pomplamoose.
Wouldn't that be funny if they were pomplamoose?
No, they're not.
They're up there too.
Everywhere.
It's like going through an Avatar movie. That one is definitely a Debbie survivor. The rain has been relentless, so it's been pouring for days, and last night, this is how much it rained. Got our own paddle pool, or bath even, freshwater bath, nice. It's been raining for days and days, relentless. So I'm just going to go and check on the dinghy to see if it's completely underwater yet. Oh, it's not too bad. Yeah, it's not letting up. So we just have to stay put. Swamp monsters returned yet again. What is this, day four? Wow, look at that.
It's incredible.
But it doesn't actually overtake the boat.
It does.
Oh, yeah. It does.
Give it time. It's
freaky.
I know.
Look at it.
I know.
It's just like taking us over.
See, this one over here.
Like a horror movie. Look, it's really quick. Oh, there's one over there.
And it, but it goes further. It always goes further up that side for some reason.
Wow, look at that. We just turned around and it was there. So that's the highlight of our day out here in the rain.
Greeting the swamp monster.
Greeting the swamp monster every day, twice a day.
Twice a day.
Yeah, because we're really stuck. We try to go out, but there's white caps in the passage, so if we go out there, it's really not much better than being in here.
Is it raining still?
Yeah. And we just had a little fire on board, but Magnus has fixed that. Got a bit of a melted something. All's good. All's good.
Yeah, we found the source of the smoke.
That was all a bit scary. Magnus smelt something funny, something burning, and we checked everything. We couldn't find anything burning. We couldn't find out where it was coming from, and then he opened the door in the aft cabin, and there was smoke in there, so we grabbed everything out of there. I was manning the fire extinguisher, and eventually he found out that there was something wrong with the VHF. So we checked it all, and then we had this massive billow of smoke coming out of there. Anyway, we're in a very narrow, shallow anchorage here. We've lost the echo sander or depth sander. So we're going to head out to clear water, well, sort of clear water, more up outside this channel, and then work out what we're going to do, because we do need some deep water, because we've lost our depth sander. Anyway, it's all very exciting here. See ya. Knots out there. Wild and woolly. Full of whitecaps out here.
Oh.
Look at these whitecaps, you've got waves. You almost go surfing. Boats in Sid Harbour, which is where we're headed. They're like a car park. Everybody's taking shelter. This relentless rain.
Nice and dry, aren't you, sweetheart? You're the chef. Oh, the hostess with the most.
I'm the chef baking the bread.
Yeah.
It's going to be the best bread ever.
Yeah, it's going to be nice.
Why
it's
going to be hot.
Why didn't we bring butter?
We don't have butter.
I know you don't. I almost
reached
for some and I thought,
no. So the little loaf has risen and it's about to go in the oven. Okay, so it's out. It's going to be hot, isn't it? Oh, that's really hot.
Yep, that's how we burnt fingers.
So, let's try just taking that off, see what happens. Oh, there it is.
You should see this loaf.
That looks pretty good. Pretty
it's
happy with that
killer.
One.
It's the best loaf you've ever done in your life.
Well, that's not hard, but thank you. I'll take that compliment.
It's a killer.
That's amazing.
Not too bad.